This video is on the topic of the inheritance of sex. In most animal populations, there is generally a 50-50 split of males and females. It is important to note that there isn't a single gene for which sex somebody is. There isn't a male gene or a female gene. There are lots of differences between the sexes that need more than one gene to code for them. Instead, a whole pair of chromosomes is needed. If we look at the chromosomes of one cell, we see 23 pairs of chromosomes arranged in size order. This is the 23rd pair, shown here. These are called XX or XY chromosomes. Remember that in our body cells, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. That's 46 individual chromosomes per cell. Examiners do like to assess this knowledge. Based on the appearance of the 23rd pair of chromosomes down a microscope, females have two X chromosomes, denoted as XX. Males have one X and one Y, denoted as XY. The Y chromosome is the smaller one. This happens according to the sperm cell that has fertilized the egg. Do you remember that XX is used to show a female and XY is used for a male? When a female makes her eggs during meiosis, she splits all her chromosome pairs. Each egg receives an X chromosome. However, when a male produces sperm, he also splits his chromosome pairs. Half of the sperm cells receive an X chromosome, the other half receive a Y. So we say that each sperm is either an X-carrying sperm or a Y-carrying sperm. Only one of these sperm will win the race to the egg and fertilize it, and this is what determines the sex of the embryo. Do note that in a sex cell, the chromosome number is halved from 46, that's 23 pairs, to 23 individual chromosomes, so that when the sex cells fuse during fertilization, there will be a full set of 46 chromosomes, or 23 chromosome pairs. This couple decide to have children together. They produce these gametes that we saw just now. The gametes can combine in these combinations. Half of these would give a female child, XX, the other half would give a male child, XY. Importantly, this is the case for each time they have a child. It's not influenced by whether they have existing children or not. So the overall chance of each sex is 50%. Or this can also be expressed as 0.5 probability or 1-to-1 ratio. This explains why the population is near enough 50% female and 50% male. Here we can see an exam-style question. A population of rabbits in a habitat was counted and the split of sexes was determined as males, 877 rabbits, females, 882 rabbits. Use your knowledge of chromosomes to explain why the ratio of the rabbit sexes was very close to 1-to-1 ratio. So the first thing about these rabbits is the number of males and females are very similar. The command word is explained, so you need to give the science behind your observations. And the question is worth 3 marks, so a reasonable amount of detail is required with 3 linking statements. Firstly, we can see that males produce an X and Y carrying sperm for 1 mark. Females produce only X-carrying eggs for a 2nd mark. This means that there's a 50% chance of a Y-carrying sperm fertilising the egg, or you can say a 50% chance of an X-carrying sperm fertilising the egg. These points would give you 1 mark. Finally, we can explain that the population will therefore be at a 1-to-1 ratio. It's important to read the question carefully and make sure you pick up on the clues provided. In summary, the sex is determined by the sperm cell that reaches the egg. Females produce eggs with an X chromosome, whereas males produce sperm cells with either an X or a Y chromosome. 50% of male sperm will carry an X, the other 50% will carry a Y chromosome. This means that fertilized eggs are 50% female and 50% male, and this represents the overall population. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.